This time we're going to talk about the end-around trick play, and that's not to be confused with an end-run design play. These are two totally different maneuvers. An end-around involves some trickery in which either a wide receiver or slot receiver or a tight end, instead of going downfield after the snap, is going to run backfield, swing around this way to accept either a handoff or a pitch out or a lateral pass from the quarterback, at which point they're going to continue around this way and try to make a play, a run play. But there are other alternatives, options we'll talk about here in just a moment. Now, this maneuver itself, the wide receiver coming around to take a pass or a handoff or a pitch out, is not technically a trick play, so it requires no bonus offensive stoppages to pull off. It's this is still an eligible receiver for a handoff, even if he's a wide receiver or a tight end or a slot receiver. We'll talk about some other options here in just a moment, but just keep in mind, when your wide receiver decides to take this maneuver, there's a cornerback here that just has a wide open lane into the backfield. So more than likely, the wide receiver or the tight end is going to have to continue to go this way rather than do some sort of reverse and come back around this way. Otherwise, he's going to get tackled by his assigned cornerback. So that's something to keep in mind. And also, if the quarterback lollygags in making this handoff, he could be tackled by this cornerback who sniffs out the play and turns his dial a little shallower so he can come in and make a sack. So that's something else to keep in mind. But like I said, this maneuver on its own does not require the expenditure of a bonus offensive stoppage. This is just another option you can use on any play. What happens next may or may not require the use of a bonus offensive stoppage. If this is going to continue to just be a simple run play in which the ball carrier, the wide receiver, or a cornerback or slot is just going to do a curl route to try to get back downfield, that's a typical running play. You'll still stop. You'll pause the action at the line of scrimmage, allow the ball carrier to do his juke move, and at which point the defense takes control of the switch, does their nanosecond bump of the board, then all unblocked players may pivot other than the ball carrier, and then the play resolves. And again, that requires no bonus offensive stoppage usage. But if the wide receiver decides to make a downfield pass prior to crossing the line of scrimmage, he can certainly do so, but that does require the use of a bonus offensive stoppage for the offense. And the pass itself will require defensive pressure sticks, if you're using those, regardless of whether this ball carrier is under defensive pressure or not. And the reason for this is that this is not a quarterback. This is a wide receiver or a tight end. They don't have as much experience throwing the ball downfield, so it's going to be a more difficult pass for them to pull off in the heat of the moment in this high-pressure, high-stakes football game. But remember, when the offense elects to use a bonus offensive stoppage, only unblocked offensive players may pivot. So that gives the offense a decided advantage when realigning eligible receivers to catch a pass. It doesn't guarantee a completion, but it does increase the odds greatly. Now, there's one other version of the end-around play, and this is one that would actually require the use of two bonus offensive stoppages. Well, let's say one or two, depending on the actions. And your call in the bootleg design play, quarterback drops back and meets a running back and executes a fake handoff, right? At which point the running back heads downfield, but the quarterback still has the ball. Well, this still applies in this version of an end-around play in which that happens. Quarterback has delivered the fake handoff, still has the ball, and at the same time, the wide receiver or tight end or slot receiver has performed this maneuver coming back. So, actually, let's set it up just a little differently. I want to reset here, and here's a better way to do it. quarterback takes the snap, drops back, and delivers a handoff or a pitch out to this running back, while at the same time, you know, we've got a fullback blocker doing whatever he's going to do, and this tight end swinging around doing this, okay? So it's a fake handoff, and this running back will continue on his way, and now what happens next is that the defense thinks he's the ball carrier, but the quarterback still has the ball. But now the quarterback is going to hand off to the, or pitch out to the end around wide out or tight end or slot receiver, who will now deliver the ball this way. In theory, knocking the entire defense out of position to make a play on this wide out. Now, this could go either way you want to plan it. But if the wideout makes a downfield pass, you will now have used two bonus offensive stoppages to execute this play. One for the fake handoff between the quarterback and the running back who's now gone this way. And then one for the pass itself. Otherwise, a fake end-around only requires one bonus offensive stoppage if the running or the wide receiver does not make a downfield pass. If he crosses the line of scrimmage, you pause the board as before, let him do his pivot, ball carrier only in this case, hand the switch over to the defense who makes their microsecond bump of the board, then all unblocked players except for the ball carrier pivot, and the play proceeds. Now, the wide receiver does not have to do a curl route and a in the same manner as a toss sweep play. They could try to shoot for a gap and run an off tackle or an end run or even a dive if they see an opening to do so. But, of course, of the nature of electric football, that's challenging. This requires the use of looping bases to pull off most of the time, or at least a base with a dial on it. Now, we'll go ahead and set one of these up. With the understanding that this is an advanced play, requires a lot of skill to pull off. Actually, let's put her halfback over here and her fullback over here. We'll try to execute the exact same play we just did. We've got the quarterback, rather than reversing his base, for demonstration purposes, I've just got him turned around. All right, so let me get the switch ready here. Here's the snap. There we go. So there's a bump and run here. That's so close, I would probably do an ability check to see who has the inside route, but we're going to go ahead and give it to the offense like so. Okay, good blocking scheme already by the offensive line. Only thing we got to watch out for is inside linebackers penetrating. Safeties don't know what's happening yet. One's going to go this way. The strong safety is going to keep an eye on the tight end who's going to swing out. And you know what? This cornerback, at least for now, is committed to a zone or a man coverage. However, wide receiver is going to go ahead and start his maneuver, and we will just try to eyeball his base. He may cut it too deep. He may cut it too shallow. Don't have a lot of practice with his wide out on his base maneuvers. Let's just look at it for a moment. Yeah, that looks awfully deep. So we'll put it back down there. Running back's going this way. Fullback is going to basically just try to stay out of the way. I do want to keep him, give some protection from this lineman here and possibly this inside linebacker. So now we'll do the read. Okay, that's probably pitch out range rather than handoff range, so we'll go ahead and enact that. But now the cornerback sees that his, he turns his head right and left and sees he doesn't have a wide out with him. So he's going to turn back around. But now look at the gap he's got to close here. That's going to be very difficult. He doesn't know what this wide out's going to do. He doesn't know how deep or shallow the loop is going to be. We're going to go ahead and pivot him a little more. And we're going to turn this quarterback. Actually, we're going to put this quarterback on a stationary base in hopes that this wideout comes to him. I don't see anything else that needs to be done. free safety is reading a run play, an in run. And yeah, I'm very happy with all this. Let's just do run a go route down here. And let's just continue to get him out of the way. Actually, you know what? Let's try to put out this fire before it develops, because this inside linebacker has a play. All right. Now, at this point, we've called a handoff and done the handoff check. It looks all everything, as far as the defense knows, the running back here has the ball. So we're going to angle him to try to stay out of the way of the wideout. That's all in theory. And what will happen next is, well, as far as the defense knows, this is the play. But it's not. Quarterback stops the board, and offensive coach announces fake, meaning he doesn't have the ball. And what a block he just made on that cornerback. Oh, that's excellent. So now comes the magic. This is the burning of the offensive stoppage here, and only the offensive players can pivot. Now, this looks interesting. We're going to go ahead and cut him deep downfield like so. I don't have my passing sticks out, so we won't be doing a pass. Everyone else, except for this running back, is blocked. So we're actually going to let him try to keep things from happening over here on the line. Nice block here by the tackle on the linebacker. I think we're ready to develop this. The wide receiver is just going to... swing around and continue his route, hopefully, to the because remember, defense cannot pivot because this is a trick play. I'm happy with this. So here we go. I hope I didn't cut that too shallow or too deep. Otherwise, he'll never make it downfield here. But I want him to get around this linebacker. So here we go. Beautiful. Now at this point, let's mark him again. And, well, he's going to get the first down, it looks like. So now we just, I just want to straighten up his base. And then we'll put him back down. Oh, I love it when these actually work, guys. Okay, I don't know that he's going to go straight here. But now at this point, the defense gains control of the switch. So we only used one bonus offensive stoppage on this play. Yeah, this cornerback has a tremendous... opportunity to make the tackle, but they'll get a first down out of this. I mean, you could use some trick. You could put some English on this dial, turn it the other way so that he does a little loop like this and gets around. I'm not going to do that for demonstration purposes, but now the defense gains control of the switch, does their bump. Okay. Yeah. Now everyone but the ball carrier can pivot, and there's really... unblocked players, that is, and honestly, I'm afraid 18's just going to get in the way. Hell, this tackle may get in the way, but the best play here is the cornerback, number 29, to make a tackle. Now, we haven't talked about defense at all yet. That's for another series, for another playlist, but the defense has to anticipate where this figure is going to be and where they're going to intersect. There's some of the head game with electric football right there. Will he make this tackle? Because he may be the only one. He may be the only one that saves this touchdown. Let's find out. Here's the resolution of the play. He did not. And number 29 scores a touchdown. So there you go. There's the effectiveness, masterfully demonstrated, I might add, of an end-around trick play in the EFHL. Hope you enjoyed that. I enjoyed it. I love it when it works. Not so much when it doesn't, but that's football, right, guys? Okay, next time we're going to talk about the reverse, I believe. See you then.